happened was that just given the same things that you mentioned, so that they will also understand much better. They were given one artist, okay? So he's a programmer, he was attached an artist, because we try to basically practice what happens in the industry. Do jan ke saath mein milke, ek artist, wo atak nahi jana chahiye ki. Design basically, theek hai, abhi filhal game ka logic jo hai wo lete. Ne kaun sa hai game ka ek logic le lo. And usko fir wo reverse engineer kara do. Artwork thoda sa change karo and aage jaise jaise jaate thoda mechanics mein thoda change karo. Thoda idhar udhar karke. Try and basically implement your idea.
Okay.
Dekhe lo.
So now this is just the storyboard section. Contains a 5-frame storyboard section. We had just created a short story regarding Mario. Like the scene was like initially we had planned for 2 levels. So there was a character called Crush, the main villain or the dragon. So he will appear at the end of the 2nd level. And now you can see where he leaves a note to Mario saying that Crush is back. And finally then the rescue begins for Mario. So this is the entire interface. So above is the heads-up display. So these are pop-up messages for Mario which give him guidelines. So basically it tells the user that he can also turn these message indications on or off anytime. And I've added some extra add-on features to the player, like you can see that plus sign over there on the heads-up display. That is nothing but just a change of camera mode, a zoom in and a zoom out effect that a player can have. So here is some kind of a small trap that the player must understand. That's why this indication is given, like jump on the colored footprint. Now basically what the player must do over here is, that is that question block over there, power block. So he must head stomp on a tortoise, kill the other. So once again head stomp him, jump on the colored brick, so the tortoise will get locked over there. And it's like a gateway pass for him for the power. So again, indication for the elevators, like
so just to basically give an idea, it's like though it's based upon Mario, but if you see it's not Mario. So the idea was they were asked to, when they got in, they were made to play a lot of games of different genre, again not sticking to anything that you like, but lot of the stuff, and then basically see what mechanics you can pick and integrate it out to here in a much better fashion.
So again, now there is like an option given to the player. So this is an indication which tells make use of the tortoise. So there are these red points below that you can see. So it depends on the player. First of all, I got this power. Now instead of killing the tortoise with the firepower, what I will do is I will headstomp once again. So the cactus will get destroyed and I will have a gate pass for collecting the points. Again, Mario can change his firing style. You can see the heads-up display icon over there. You can have a sonic style or a wavy pattern. So this is a wavy pattern. And then, like, I jumped on the colored brick and the cactus got destroyed. So this is like a 10-tap coin. This is the end of the 1st level. This is where the 2nd level starts.
Actually, I think we go to the next one. Questions?
Yeah, yeah, sure.
So how much time it took to make this?
I think we should be able to give you the top answer, because he's a main program. The artist has basically decided to skip today's event. So Akshay, you can answer that question.
Almost it took like 2.5 months just for his two levels and the menu interface. Probably even more than that. 2.5 to 3 months.
What language used?
Basically we designed everything in GM Maker, so GML language. The language provided by GM Maker.
Which is again derived from Java.
Right.
It's kind of based on Java.